would be impossible, i.e. settlement rights for all Gurkhas.
She says, Norman, you won the Nobel Prize.
Witness history on BBC World News.
It's African dance music.
Jazz music merged with
some hip-hop elements.
How can they make decisions about the future of Afghanistan when they do not even allow women to be in those conferences?
Нет, Россия не белая, не пушистая. Россия такая, какая она есть. И мы не стыдимся показывать себя такими, какими мы есть.
The way to counter Russia is through strength.
Everyone was white, and I said, where is everybody else? And I promised myself I'd fight for equality the rest of my life.
Politics in Kenya has been around people who have brands. Either your father was this or your father was that.
When big names talk, they talk to the BBC.
Alone we break the rules. Together we make the rules. Alone they say we are feisty. Together we are fearless. Shout alone they call us hysterical. Shout together we can be historical. This is a new perspective, inclusive, not selective. One will sacrifice, we all make a gain. One wins, we all take the prize. One stands, we all rise. Join us in celebrating 10 years of 100 Women on BBC World News.
This is BBC News, broadcasting to viewers in the UK and around the world. I'm Nancy Kachungira, the headlines. There have been long queues and emotional scenes at airports in China, which has fully opened its borders for the first time since the start of the pandemic.
The number of COVID cases that simply couldn't be controlled by the zero COVID lockdown policy was almost certainly becoming so great that the change would have had to come within the next couple of months anyway.
The UK Prime Minister Rishi Sunak says the government will discuss a pay deal that's affordable with the nurses' union to settle strikes. That's welcomed by the biggest nursing union as a chink of optimism. President Biden will visit the US border with Mexico for the first time since taking office today. Record numbers of migrants have crossed over recently. Hello and welcome. Thank you for joining us when we're going to begin with some breaking news. We're hearing that thousands of supporters of the former president of Brazil, Jair Bolsonaro, have stormed the country's National Congress in Brasilia. They've clashed with the police, who used tear gas in an attempt to repel them. The right-wing former leader lost the last presidential election to the socialist Luiz Inácio Lula da Silva, who was sworn in last week. Well, Mr. Bolsonaro's supporters are calling for military intervention and the resignation of Mr. Lula da Silva. Now, footage that's circulating online shows angry protesters wrapped in the national flag with police erecting barricades around the building. And we'll bring you more on that as soon as we have it. Elsewhere, China has reopened its borders to international visitors for the first time since the start of the pandemic. People entering the country will no longer need to quarantine, but will need to provide proof of a negative COVID test. And Chinese citizens are once again allowed to go overseas. There have been emotional reunions at airports and the mainland's border with Hong Kong. This latest lifting of coronavirus restrictions coincides with the country's busiest travel season, marking the Lunar New Year. Our correspondent Martin Yip sent us this report.